So if I want to sit down for a session of PUBG Mobile, this phone isn't gonna cut it. For that, I need the ROG phone, the fastest phone in the world. So we're here at Computex and ASUS has unveiled a bit of a surprise. This is the ROG phone, a gaming phone from its ROG division. Now this thing is incredible. And not the least of it is the fact that it has what's called SpeedBin processors. Now you've probably heard of SpeedBinning for the PC, where you sort of cherry pick the fastest chip on the block, give it to a gaming PC manufacturer and allow it to be overclocked to, who knows, 5 GHz or higher. This actually takes a SpeedBin Qualcomm Snapdragon 845. This is the latest chip from Qualcomm. It's the chip that's being used in a number of smartphones. This has been cherry-picked so it can run at 2.96 GHz. So again, if you're talking about gaming, you want the absolutely fastest chip that you can use, and this delivers. Now, what makes this particular phone special, of course, is the fact that it has just a number of things, and everything is really designed for gaming. Let's take the panel, for example. DCI 3, it's an AMOLED, 90 hertz refresh rate, one millisecond response time. Again, we're talking about the differences of less than a millisecond, the key that would differentiate the fact between you being dead and you winning a match of Battle Royale. The phone itself the specs itself are extremely powerful. We have 512 gigabytes of storage, 8 gigs of memory. Inside it is the Adreno 630, and it also has a 4,000 milliamp hour battery. Now, you might have noticed too, this particular cooling solution in the back. You're wondering yourself, what exactly is this? Now this is actually an active cooling solution. And it's one of the accessories that comes with the ROG phone. It's got cooling on the sides, it's got USB-C ports as well as a headphone jack, and it slides into the side of the phone. Now what's interesting about the side of the phone is that ROG decided that you're going to be gaming with this on a regular basis. You don't want to actually have a cord that comes out either the top or the bottom. So it actually has a side charging slot. And so this not only works with this particular device right here, but it actually just works with a charger. If you want to go ahead and hold it and play your games, that's fine. You don't have to worry about losing battery life. Now this is actually just one of a number of different accessories that comes with the phone. So instead of just the cooling solution, we have an actual handheld dock. We have a second screen display. Oh, here we go. And you can see, look at this thing. I mean, this looks like just the Nintendo Switch on either side of a phone. Couple of pair of joysticks here, buttons. A number of different controls that you want to go ahead and use. Now, the one thing that's interesting about this is the fact that it has a couple of shoulder buttons, an R2 and R1 here, an L2 and an L1 here. Sure, you say, what's new and special about this? Well, nothing in particular on this bit, but those shoulder buttons actually appear on the phone as well, apparently. So,
explain that.
What we have is the fact that on this particular phone, we have what's called ultrasonic shoulder buttons. We actually haven't tried them. So ideally what would happen is when you're playing, you can go ahead and control the action with your thumbs. And we were told that pro gamers actually use essentially 4 fingers to control everything from left and right motion to scrolling to shooting and so forth to switching between weapons. But again, there's going to be some ultrasonics coming out of the top shoulder buttons here that allow you to actually control the action with your fingers up here as well as the thumbs on your screen. Again, we haven't tried this in action, but this sounds like kind of a unique feature that, if it works, could make a significant difference in, the lives of what we're called our professional gamers, as well as just ordinary Joes like you and I. So this is actually a two-screen peripheral. Now, why would you need something like this? Well, ASUS tells us they're actually going to be working with the game developers to go ahead and build in dual-screen support for this. So you can have your phone up here and a second screen down here performing some sort of independent functions. You might have seen this, for example, with some of the Nintendo devices where you have a main screen and then you have the other screen being used for a map or something of that sort. Now, in addition to this, we have something that's a little bit more conventional but still pretty amazing for a gaming phone, and that's actually just a PC dock. So again, you plug your phone in here and you actually would have you'd be able to play your game with a mouse and keyboard. Something that Microsoft's tried before with Continuum. We've seen it before with Android, but again, I mean, you can imagine the advantage you'd get if you're playing something like Fortnite or PUBG with a mouse and keyboard as opposed to just your thumbs. So the one thing we don't know about this is the price. ASUS tells us that it's going to be released in the third quarter for an undisclosed price, expected to be on the high end. Smartphones are already pushing $1,000 anyways. In any case, we will be eager to get our hands on it, test it to its full, and look forward to receiving it a little bit later on this year.